The skin condition called acanthosis nigricans, fortunately, is uncommon, but pseudoacanthosis nigricans, unfortunately, isn't. If you were formally schooled in Latin, you know exactly what I'm talking about. But if you weren't, stay tuned. Hello, I'm Dr. Neil Schultz, and welcome to DermTV. Let's start with what acanthosis nigricans, which I'm going to refer to as AN in this episode, start with what it looks like, which will then make you want to know more about it. And just to make it a little more interesting, the real AN and faux AN, which is the more common pseudoacanthosis nigricans, they look essentially identical. Since acanthosis just means a thickening or overgrowth of the upper layers of your skin, and nigricans really means dark or black, if we put it together, we really get a descriptive term from which you expect to see a dark overgrowth or thickening of your skin. AN appears as tan to dark, brown, velvety surface plaques with parallel lines, which when they're even deeper, they look like velvety parallel ribs, like the nap of carpeting. You usually get it on the parts of your body where skin tends to rub against skin, like the underarms, your neck, and the upper inner thighs, but it can occur in other places as well. Because these brown, raised, unattractive patches and plaques don't itch, they don't burn, in any other way bother you, except cosmetically, which is personally important and a real quality of life issue, the medical importance of AN is why it occurs and whether it reflects something important internally. Most cases of AN are not true AN, but fortunately the pseudoform, which occurs from being overweight. The real AN comes from certain endocrine diseases like diabetes, polycystic ovary syndrome, and other less common hormonal imbalances, but the most importantly, acanthosis nigricans can be a reflection of an internal cancer, which most commonly are malignancies of the gastrointestinal tract, uterus, and sometimes even the lung, prostate, breast, or ovary. And last, there are some people who have AN with no apparent associated disease, and they're not overweight. For the first group, whose AN is associated with obesity, endocrine problems, or cancers, treating the underlying condition will result in a remarkable improvement of the acanthosis. But what about those people who fortunately don't have any disease causing this, but they still have the cosmetic impact of thickened brown skin? For those people, there are ways of minimizing the cosmetic impact of this unusual rash. Because it's caused by thickening and darkening of the skin, treatment with products that bleach the extra brown and reduce the dead layers of skin are helpful. So believe it or not, even with the unusual, here we are back to treatment with exfoliants and bleaches once again. Please join me again at DermTV.com. If you have a question, please send it to me by visiting DermTV.com/question. I'm Dr. Neil Schultz, and thank you for watching today.